and iron's regular iron, and then you fold pig iron with coke, or in our case magma, and pig iron bars. So iron and pig iron make steel. Okay, so it's just basically a way to heat the iron at a super temperature, and it gets rid of more impurities, and that's what steel is. It's basically, the more oxygen you can get out of the steel during the smelting process, the harder the product's going to be. And then you fold it into regular iron, and you get steel. Let's see how... I'm gonna make another stockpile. Let's see. Yeah, and this is just gonna be purely for... iron-based products. Just make it closer to our smelters. Let's go ahead and see what's around here. So the giant elm was killed, the cave crocodile, the giant toads. Let's see if there's any other interesting animals around. Yeah, another giant toad. Goblin thieves. There's a pawn grabber. These things are crazy. A small creature lives in watery ditches deep underground. It has a sharp beak and four tentacles with claws at the end. What it'll do is it'll grab a dwarf and pull him into the water and drown him. It's crazy, huh? Pretty vicious. Dwarves really aren't known for their ability to swim either. Alright, so they're gonna start hauling all the iron material down here, which I should have done before. I did here, however, set that up. As you can see, oh, I didn't. Let's block all hematite, limonite, magnetite. Now it's set. But until they start cleaning that up, there it all comes. Excellent. Load us up, boys. Right on. That's gonna be really good. So I can't get the diamonds because of the water, so that sucks. It's gonna have a diamond wall there, I guess. Yeah, I still haven't started making pig iron. Once we have steel weapons, nothing's gonna stop us. We also have the adamantium there, so maybe we'll make some adamantium axes, or swords, or spears, or something. Leading the fighting demonstration, watching one, leading a dodging demonstration, individual combat drill. It's good stuff. notice that no creatures have come along this bottom edge. Sometimes you'll have like clans of troglodytes, but we haven't had that problem here. I've even had ant people. Yep, ant people. So, and bat people. Dwarves are sparring, they're getting better. See some of the trees have begun growing back. We cut down this forest a long time ago. And all that. See that they began mining all that out, which is nice. Just kind of opened it up. Have a better field of vision. I should consider making a tunnel. Chop them down, boys. Yeah. Wild West. Chop down whatever we want. Deforestation. Underground deforestation. So they've just begun making some pig iron, as you can see. He's making some iron bars there, so now he's going to be working on pig iron. Awesome. So he's some marble. So he takes marble. You could also take chalk, stuff like that. And then he's combining it with iron to make pig iron. See? Already made one. Awesome. Getting our pig iron made. After pig iron is steel. And after steel, we send to the metal. Metalsmiths, the armorsmiths, and the weaponsmiths, and it's gonna be good stuff, real good stuff. Steel is gonna make our guys almost impervious, especially to these goblins. Our guys are gonna be able to cleave through the goblins. It's gonna make our warriors much stronger. So we won't have to just hide here in our fort. Because I guarantee if I sent out our army to go after the goblins only in iron armor, the goblins are also wearing iron armor, they would slaughter our dwarves. Right down to the last dwarf. So I don't want to see that happen. I want to see battles more in our favor. Of course, our dwarves, clad in what they are right now, would do really well against, like, troglodytes, unarmored opponents. We would just cleave right through them. Nothing would stop us, except for opponents in the same type of armor, and with weapons like that. Because the skill of our dwarves really isn't that great right now. We haven't had much combat. So the goblins probably have really good, highly trained goblins. They're really not that strong by themselves, but they're highly trained, so. And pretty well armored, but we can beat them. We can beat them. We will beat them bad, too. Platinum, eh? To get some more of that platinum. Ugh. Migrants. Migrants have arrived. Station the mountainous owls. And the dust of inking. And we'll open up the lever. Let all these migrants in, and then it should all be good. Glassmaker, yee. 64-year-old glassmaker. Mugar. Alright guys, I'm gonna take a break here while the migrants come on in. We pissed the elves off yet again. That is our nature. And trying to trade them with fungus wood stuff, and that pissed them off. It's like, do they even know what fungus wood looks like? Silly elves. You know what? Well, the gates are open. Yes, we'll have them finish our wall. With our favorite material. Nice. Alrighty.